ekber, Allahu ekber. Allahu ekber, Allahu ekber. Eşhedü en la ilahe illallah. Eşhedü en la أشهد أن محمد رسول الله أشهد أن محمد رسول الله حي على الصلاة Allah-u Teala fi kitab-ı razîm. Evzü billahi mineşşeytanirracîm. Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Ve hafûni in kuntum mûminîn. Sadakallahu lezîm. Allah-u Teala says in the Kur'an-ı Kerim, and fear me if you are a believer. Now, alhamdulillah, we are believers. But I ask ourselves, do we really, truly fear Allah Ta'ala? Thank you. We have to say yes. But if we do, we are lying. If we say no, we are kafir. So perhaps best is to be silent. I said that if we said yes, we would be lying. Why? Some of you may say. Because if we would truly be fearing Allah Ta'ala, we can hardly stand up. We should be in the position of sajda at all times. In fact, not the way we make sajda, like the Christians, like flat on our faces with our arms stretched out in awe and in fear of Allah Ta'ala. We don't even know what fear of Allah is. Did we even sit down and think what fear is? When I was suspected that I had cancer, and when they were making those tests and analysis and everything else, I must admit that I was afraid. I was afraid if I had cancer. But once they told me I had cancer, I wasn't afraid at all. It was what it was. I mean, either I was going to die or I was going to get cured. But the idea was much more fearful than the thing itself. So fear does not happen at the present. I mean, even if I was in the middle of a burning house or a battlefield, I wouldn't be afraid. Fear is either to be afraid in the future some terrible, hateful thing will happen to me, or in the future something which I love, I will lose. So, one fears the invisible. In that sense, there is a correspondence of fear of Allah to the ordinary fear. Because Allah Ta'ala is invisible also. What is the thing which we fear most in life? Death, isn't it? I mean, it's one thing which is definitely going to happen. That's the only thing sure in life. Because we are born, we are going to die. Yet we are terrified of it. Now think, why are we afraid of death? Are we afraid of the pain of death? It seems there are many occasions in life that we go through pain which is much less than the pain which we are going to have when we are going to die. So what we are or should be afraid of? Somebody came to Bishop his deathbed and the visitor said, "Ya Bishop, if Allah Ta'ala so wills, he will make you, inshallah, cured and back in good health." Bishr al-Hafif al-Jusr Rahif al-Sahi looked at the visitor. He said, "Do you think that I am afraid of death?" "No," he said. "The reason that I am crying," because he was crying, "is to meet one's Lord is a very serious matter," said Bishr al-Hafif. And again, likewise, somebody went and visited Abu Bakr in Ibn Furq, who was also in his deathbed and who was also crying. And the visitor said that, "I'm shocked that you are crying. Are you afraid of death?" He said, "No, I'm not afraid of death. I am afraid of that will happen after death." When the ayat was revealed to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in Surah Al-Mu'minun, it says, "And those who gave what they gave away while their hearts are filled with fear that to their Lord they must return." The hadith is related by Hazrat Aisha radiallahu anha. So she said, "Ya Rasulullah, does Allah Ta'ala mean in this ayat the sinners, the ones who debauched, who drank wine, who hurt other people, who committed adultery?" "Nay, ya Aisha," said Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, "this ayat was revealed for those mu'min who make their prayers, who fast during Ramadan, and who do everything which Allah Ta'ala has ordered them to do. But there is the fear in their hearts that all their actions and all the good that they do may not be accepted." So the fear of Allah is not for the kafir. The fear of Allah is not for the sinner. The fear of Allah is for us. One day, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sitting with Ashab al-Kiram, and he said, "Do you know who is the muflis?" Iflas, what does it mean in Arabic? Bankruptcy. Muflis is someone who is bankrupt. He asked three times. At the end, someone the Ashab said, "Ya Rasulullah, a muflis is the person who has nothing which belongs to him anymore, and he has got lots of debt, and he cannot pay his debt." He said, "No. A muflis is us. A muflis is a good mu'min," said Rasulullah, "who has all his life made his prayers, paid his zakah, fasted during Ramadan, and tried his best to follow what Allah Ta'ala asked us to do, except that he was not considerate and kind to his fellow brothers. He took things from them and he didn't return it back. He criticized them and broke their hearts. He fought with them. And on the day of Yom Kippur, when he has to pay his accounting, Allah Ta'ala will ask those people who he has tyrannized to give their sins to him, or rather to give first their good deeds to him. No, take from him his good deeds as a payment of what they have done to him, and when he runs out of the good deeds to give to them, then he will receive the sins of the people who he has tyrannized. So that, he says, is the mercy. But please, don't think we are neither Muftis nor we are afraid of Allah Ta'ala. We think we are good Muslims. And what we can expect from Allah Ta'ala is only reward. Because we make our prayers 5 times a day and pray our zikr and fast during Ramadan. Iblis, the shaitan al-lahim, before he was cursed and thrown from Allah's mercy, some say he was a jinn. Some say he was an angel. And his name was Haris. What is Haris? Haris is ambitious. And when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was climbing in Miraj towards Allah Ta'ala, he passed through 8 heavens. And each of the 8 heavens he has seen a palace in ruins, made out of jewels. And Ya Jibreel, which prophet, which angel lived in those palaces? Ya Rasulullah, those are the palaces of Haris, of Iblis. He prayed 10,000 years in this palace, 100,000 years in that palace, and 50,000 years in that palace. He was so ambitious of Allah Ta'ala's approval, not 5 times a day, but thousands of years he had made prayers to Allah Ta'ala. And because of the pride, precisely like us, because we are making our prayers, we are so great, that he revolted to Allah Ta'ala when he asked him to prostrate in front of Hazrat Adam alayhi salam. He refused. He said, you made me out of fire and made him out of earth, and fire is superior to earth. Stupidity. Out of stupidity and only one sin, one disobedience to Allah Ta'ala, he was punished, being thrown from the mercy of Allah Ta'ala till eternity. And so here is someone who counted and who was proud of his prayer. Kicked by Allahu Teala's mercy. But when this incident happened, Jibril Aleyhisselam and Mikael Aleyhisselam was caught crying. And Allahu Teala said, Ya Jibril, Ya Mikael, why are you crying? Are you sad? Because I have kicked him out of my mercy. No, Ya Rab, it is not for that. We are afraid, said Jibril alayhi salam and Mikael alayhi salam, that it could happen to us too. Who do we think we are to feel secure? They are afraid of Allah Ta'ala. Hazreti Adem Aleyhisselam is in paradise. What better place there is to feel secure than the paradise? He also did one thing wrong, and he was kicked out of paradise. We live in the world, which is a swamp, which is in all directions, comes as occasion for us to sin. Now, what is the remedy? Which transforms the fear into a hope. Someone came to Hazreti Rabia bin Adviya, and he asked her, I am a sinner, said he. Ya Rabia, if I repent, if I make tawbah to Allah Ta'ala, will he turn towards me? No, said Hazrat Rabia. If Allah Ta'ala turns towards you, only then you can make tawbah. Fear Allah. And make tawbah. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, التائب من الذنب كمن لا ذنب له. He who repents for his sins is as if he has not sinned at all. Not only do we fear Allah, but we also do not make tawbah. Allahu Ta'ala is one of the greatest gifts to the Muslim. He has made certain places and certain times on the face of this world and in our lives, during which days and places, well, if we are there, Allah's mercy is without exception. One of these days is coming very soon. Shahr Ramadan is around the corner. The 3 months of Rajab and Shaban and Ramadan is starting next week. Next week, Thursday, is Laylatul Raghaib, the first Friday night of the month. sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem fesletmiş. Recep is Allah's month. Şaban is my month. And Ramazan is the month of Ümmet-i Muhammed. Recep is the time to fast, is the time to repent. Resulullah sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem once was passing through a graveyard and he started crying. He started crying that his blessed beard was wet. And the ashab asked him, what is happening, Ya Rasulullah? Have you received a revelation? He said, no. I see that my ummah, who are buried in this graveyard, they are all in pain and being tortured. Azab al-Qabr. And he said, that if one day in the month of Rajab, they would have fasted and made tawbah to Allah Ta'ala, that would not have happened to them. If one of you will have a bag of dollars and you will go to the brook and start throwing those dollars, you know, into the water, or if one of you would set fire to his house, we would call him crazy. But why don't people call us crazy? Because we spend something which is much more valuable than money and house every minute of our life. That is the time. Because somebody who throws his money away can gain it back. Who burns his house can build it back. But that minute which has passed, I will never get it back. So ibadallah, know the value of time. Know the gifts of Allah Ta'ala in which we have got an occasion to make tawbah and repent and pay for our sin and fear Allah Ta'ala. You are believers. May Allah have mercy on us. Amen. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, who has created us in the beautiful form and shape of a human being from a drop of dirty water. We were hungry, you fed us. We were nude, you dressed us. You have given us two servants who have taken care of us all our lives, those we call our mothers and fathers. And every minute of our lives, from the moment we set foot on that planet, till the time that we will come to you, at every breath, each time we eat and drink, each time we get sick and we get cured, Ya Rab, you have blessed us with billions of gifts which we cannot possibly count. But your greatest gift, Ya Rab, is that you have blessed us with Iman. Alhamdulillah. The greatest gift, Ya Rab, you have blessed us with Islam. Alhamdulillah. And you have appointed the one who is your best creation. Hayri Halkullah, Şefi El-Müzidin, Rahmeten Lil-Alemin, Hazreti Muhammed Mustafa sallallahu aleyhi ve sellem, as our example, as our model, as our mürşid, our teacher, as our intercessor, for all those gifts, Ya Rab, we, alas, have been thankless. Ya Rab, forgive this cemaat.
Amen.
Forgive all of Ummet-i Muhammed. Forgive all of humanity. And teach us to be thankful.
Amen.
And count us amongst your thankful servants.
Amen.
For all these gifts and blessings which you pour upon your creation, sometimes, not often, and never above our endurance, you test us. You test us, our obedience to you, our faith to you, our love for you, not that you know not, so that we ourselves know the extent of our iman. You test us with little sickness, little pain, little poverty, little hunger, taking from us things which we think are ours, but they are in reality yours. And Ya Rab, although you say, Inna Allahumma as-sabirin, you are side by side supporting those of us who show patience. None of us show patience. On the contrary, we complain about you to your creation. We complain about you to our lawyers, to our doctors, to our wives, to our children. Oh, shame on us. Ya Rabbi, have mercy on this Jamaat. Have mercy upon Ummet-i Muhammed. Have mercy upon all humankind. And teach us all patience and thankfulness, and count us amongst your patience and thankful servants. Amin. Bismillah. Seyyidem müsterihim. Ta'ala yasin. Allahümme salli ala seyyidina Muhammedin mahtefer merevan. Ve takabel asaran. Ve kerevel vezidan. Ve stekbeler ferkadan. Ve benim ve ruhahu ervah ehli beytihi min akayyatı ve selam. Ve barik ve sellem aleyhi kesiren kesiren kesiren. Ve sallallahu ala seyyidina Muhammedin ve ala cemil enbiyai vel mürselin ve evliyai ve salihin ve ala melaiketike vel mukarrabin ve ala ehli taatike ecmaine min ehli semavati ve ehli ardin ve rızvanullahi teala ala ali resulullahi ve sahbihi ecmain. Amin ve elhamdülillahi rabbil alemin.